Welcome back, beautiful people. It's time for another episode of Trey, the Terrible Collector. On today's episode, we are going to be unboxing the evil mutant geneticist Nathaniel Essex, Mr. Sinister.
Who are you? What do you want with us?
My name is Sinister. Mr. Sinister.
Now, this Mr. Sinister is our first variant figure. The variant figures were rare, or figures that you could only get at certain locations that had something that was a little bit different than the vast majority of them. This Mr. Sinister has a red cape, whereas the standard one came with a blue cape. When I was little, I did have a blue cape Mr. Sinister. This one was a KB Toys exclusive. So the exclusive figures... I mean, the back is red, nothing too exciting about that, but the difference, I think, is going to be once we get this box open. As before, you will see we have the villains up in the upper right-hand corner. That means we only have Magneto left in this bunch of toys. Down here at the bottom, it says he has a power light blast. He's got a little jewel in his chest that's meant to light up. I am absolutely certain that that will not work, but on the back... it shows how to use it and how to change the batteries. So while some of my other figures have batteries that are permanently dead and will never work again, this one at least has the ability to pop those out and put some new ones in. The card is in relatively good shape. The artwork is pretty cool and dynamic. If you ever watched the X-Men animated series TV show, you will know that he was the big bad from the second series. He was terrifying to me as a kid. He had like these shark teeth, and his voice was, I'm Mr. Sinister. Really horrifying. I'm going to go ahead and bust this open. And I'm just going to ruin it. There we go. In here we have a trading card from the FLIR Ultra series. It is a original Beast. Cool. We'll get to that in a second. And here we have the Mr. Sinister. So his cape is a very cool, solid sculpt. The only cape that we've seen so far in the series is Magneto's fabric cape from the first one. And then you've got like this kind of weird balloon fabric that Banshee and Gambit have. But this hard plastic is a very nice look, and it doesn't detract too much from his flexibility. The button to control his light goes right through the cape, so you can access it. Obviously, it doesn't still work, but we'll change the batteries out here at some point. The cape comes off easily. And when we get in here, there's some really cool things. First of all, the pallid skin, the jet black eyes, a very... almost demonic, vampiric look to a character. His mouth is open and showing his teeth. Much more expressive than some of the other figures in the line. The Wolverine 3 and the Sabretooth are also pretty expressive, but this one is very cool and unique. Tons of detail in his body, armor. Every line is in there very nicely. The thigh-high boots, nice touch. And then little detail of the red around the ankle boots. Are very cool. He does have great flexibility. His legs bend. They bend at the knees. His head doesn't, because there's wiring in there and having the electric figures. None of them ever had a head that moved. But he looks really, really cool. And he looks even better with his variant red cape. I'm going to turn around too. The cape looks awesome. There's tons of detail on it. Really fleshed out. It's not just like a simple thing. Can we get him to stand? Yes. Excellent. All right. That brings us to our... today's extra fact is about Hank McCoy, the X-Man known as the Beast. Despite his physical appearance and his strength and agility, he's mostly known for his incredible mind. He's a brilliant doctor and geneticist, but several times over the years, he's pushed the boundaries too far. Currently in the X-Men lineup, I'm not going to give any spoilers, but he's got some really crazy things going on.
and he's also responsible for changing himself into the Blueford version that we're familiar with because he was doing experiments and testing on himself.
There you have it, the Beast. Cool. As you can see, we are really making some headway in this series. It's very cool to see all these guys out next to each other. Even the ones who are underwhelming look really cool when all in the group like this. You're starting to get some very dynamic looks. The Iceman, the Sauron, and Mr. Sinister all look very different than the rest of the figures. And it makes me even more excited for the last two we have coming up. I know that we just had one a couple of episodes ago, and you're probably sick of hearing about him. But next week, we're going to bust open another Wolverine figure. So please tune in. Remember to like and subscribe. Leave me a comment in the comments if you feel so inclined. And tell your friends. Word of mouth is the best way to get more people checking out our show. So thank you very much for watching. Y'all have been wonderful, and I have been terrible. I'll see you again soon.